मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे विल स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर इन क्लास 7 बायोलॉजी एंड द चैप्टर इज लेसन 4 दैट इज प्लांट लाइफ. यू ऑल नो दैट व्हाट इज न्यूट्रिशन इन द प्लांट लाइफ. विल स्टडी अबाउट द न्यूट्रिशन, हाउ द फूड इज प्रिपेयर्ड बाय द प्लांट्स, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट रिक्वायरमेंट्स फॉर द फोटोसिंथेसिस एज वेल एज what is the structure of the chloroplast. Today we'll discuss in the class. So first of all, what is nutrition? Nutrition means it is the process of providing food by an organism for their growth, development and to carry out vital activities. So food is required by all, either by the plants also require food as well as animals. And we all know that plants require food, and the food which is prepared by the plants, they itself can absorb the food, and that food is also provided to the animals. So according to the nutrition, the types of nutrition may be categorized. The nutrition is divided into two types. First one is the autotrophic nutrition and the second is heterotrophic nutrition. So autotrophic nutrition means, auto means self. Here it is derived from the two words auto and troph. Auto means self and trophic means feed. Means those organisms which produce their own food, they are called autotrophs, or that mode of nutrition is called autotrophic nutrition. Like plants are mostly, they show the autotrophic nutrition, means plants are called autotrophs and they are also called producers because they produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis. And the second type is heterotrophic nutrition, in which the organisms obtain the food which is derived from plants, or they can also take the food from the other animals. So hetero means others and troph means food, feed. So those animals who depend on others for their food, they are called heterotrophs. But here in this chapter we are describing about the plant life, so we will only discuss about the plants. The plants do the process of photosynthesis by the help of carbon dioxide and water. So in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, they prepare glucose, that is the food. And this glucose is eaten by the animals, or we can say it is also absorbed by the plants also for their growth and other purpose. And as a result of photosynthesis, the oxygen is liberated in the atmosphere. So here you might have understood what is photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is a process in which the food is prepared by green plants in the presence of sunlight, water, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. And so here only we can sum up that the basic requirements of the photosynthesis are carbon dioxide first. So as I told you, carbon dioxide, mostly the plants get the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. And how this carbon dioxide is taken by the plants? So these are absorbed by the plants by the small pores or the openings which are present on the undersurface of the leaf. These are called stomata. And this carbon dioxide is absorbed by the process of diffusion. Now the second requirement of the plant is water. That is, you all know that water is absorbed by the roots of the plant, and 1% of the total water is absorbed by the plants, and this water is absorbed by the plants by the xylem. Xylem is a conducting tissue which are present in the roots, and this xylem conducts the water to the stem, and from the stem the water is conducted to the leaves. Now the third main basic requirement, that is the chlorophyll. You all know chlorophyll is the green pigment which are present in the plant, and these, the leaves of the green plant, they trap the sunlight by this chlorophyll only. And if we study, the chlorophyll is actually the green pigment which are present in the chloroplast. So what is chloroplast? Chloroplast is actually the oval shaped organelles. They are found in photosynthesizing cells of the different plants, as well as it is also found in some algae. If we study the structure of the chloroplast, then it consists of the two and three layers. The first is, it consists of the double membrane layer, that is called stroma. And this stroma which are double membrane structure. They have flattened coin like structures which are called the matrix, in which the thylakoids are stacked together, and these are called the stromal lamellae, which are stacked together one by one layer. They are arranged in the piles, and these are called the stromal lamellae. Now you all know that the glucose which is prepared by the plants, they are mostly prepared in the leaves, and that's why leaves are also called the which contain chlorophyll, because it contains green pigment called chlorophyll, and that's why it is called kitchen of the plant. So it prepared the food, and this glucose which is prepared in the leaves, it is transported to various parts of the plant by the conducting tissue called phloem. Just now I told you about the xylem. Xylem is a conducting tissue which transport the water from the stem to the leaves, and here phloem is the conducting tissue which transport the prepared food by the green plants to the different parts of the plants for different activities. Now I will discuss what are the factors affecting the photosynthesis. There are mostly four factors which affect the photosynthesis. First is the light intensity. We all know that if the intensity of light is more, the photosynthesis also increases, and if the intensity of the light is less, the photosynthesis decreases. But here one thing I want to tell you, that higher light intensity also can decrease the rate of photosynthesis. Second is the temperature. We all know that the photosynthesis takes place between the temperature 25 to 35 degrees Celsius. And if it is more than 35 degrees Celsius, means if it exceeds 35 degrees Celsius, means the photosynthesis rate might decrease. Third one is the carbon dioxide concentration. If the concentration of the carbon dioxide is proper or normal for the photosynthesis will take place. And if it is much more, more carbon dioxide, then also it can affect the photosynthesis. And the last factor is water, H2O, and it also helps in increasing the turgidity of the cell. And we all know that our water is absorbed by the roots. From the roots it is transported to the xylem, then to the stem and to the leaves. So water is very important part, or the factor we can say, for the which affect the photosynthesis. So here we have studied the four factors: light intensity, temperature, carbon dioxide and water. Other topics I will discuss tomorrow. Thank you.